Previously on the Better Buildings Challenge Swap.
What would happen with this salad?
It gets tossed out.
It might be an excellent opportunity to come through the entire space and relamp the entire space with the most energy efficient lighting system.
A rivalry that stretches from the seven seas to the wild blue yonder. Get seriously energy efficient. U.S. Naval Academy, U.S. Air Force Academy, hosted by Maria Vargas from the U.S. Department of Energy. Two teams swapped.
Good morning, team. Vice Admiral Ted Carter here, Superintendent of the United States Naval Academy. It's great to have our Navy team here, ready to go, new adventure. Our Air Force friends come in from Colorado Springs, visiting us here in Tecumseh Court, Annapolis, Maryland.
When we arrived in Annapolis and then subsequently into the Naval Academy, I could definitely tell that our home field advantage had been taken away from us. But we look forward to being here. We play well on the road.
Maria, great to host you here as well.
Well, thank you so much for having us. We're very excited about the swap and what we can find today. So with that, Navy team, are you ready to go?
Yes.
Go Navy.
All right. Air Force, are you ready?
Yeah, go Air Force.
All right. Lead on.
These two organizations really are leaders. They also offer a huge example for other college campuses and universities.
We've become a logistics-based Navy, and to come up with alternative energies and alternative ways to keep ourselves steaming on the seas, to stay on station longer, go farther, is just part of the culture of the Navy.
The U.S. Naval Academy has a wide range of buildings. Many of them are historic, over 100 years old. We find that maintaining the appearance while integrating new technologies to provide better energy savings is very challenging.
So now welcome to my home. This is Bancroft Hall. This is the rotunda. We have Memorial Hall up there. This is the dormitory for all 4,400 midshipmen. We have attached is our cafeteria. We have a barber shop. We have a midshipman store. Shall we take a look?
Got a lot of mix of lighting in here.
Yeah. It's funny to look at all the
lots
of lights
thinking,
on.
That's a very
to illuminate where the windows are. So.
Yeah, that's a lot of light for next to a window wall.
Yeah.
And those ones aren't super decorative, so not necessary.
You could turn some of them off and leave some of these that give the space its ambiance on.
But wow, it's just awesome.
Well, you can really feel the difference between the unconditioned space and this space here in the dorm.
Feels great.
I don't know what temperature you think it's at though. It's pretty cool in here.
Wow, and then in a different hallway, it still feels conditioned, but it's even warmer than before.
Yeah, it must be, we'll have to see. It must be something where, you know, just a building this size, keeping it all conditioned the same way has got to be a challenge.
We're very proud of the work we've done so far. And I don't mind saying it felt a little awkward having them point out little details or misses on projects that we've either considered or executed or plan to do in the future.
Whatever the set point they have this at, it feels mighty cool in here. Yeah, I don't know if I would cool it quite as much.
And it seems like a small thing, but when you think about, I don't know how many rooms there are, but the biggest dorm in the US.
This is a 1.4 million square foot facility, so I mean, you multiply it by that size, just a dollar a square foot is $1.4 million. So well, you can save a dollar a square foot.
The temperature might have to do with the fact that this dorm is really low. So like maybe that dorm is really hot right now, even though it's at the same set point. And then this one feels really cool because it's down lower than the others and there's no sun on it right now.
Yeah, that could get back to kind of the idea of individual controls or having a little bit of control over
definitely.
The room.
So
it's funny, 25 years ago,
I saw pictures.
Our Air Force Academy furniture looked like this.
Yeah, it looked like this. And this
we
is only a two-man.
Maybe shipped ours here. They got our leftovers.
Some of the findings that they had did represent some worthwhile follow-up work on our part. But I think it also demonstrated the kind of challenge we have dealing with historical buildings and monumental structures.
King Hall was great, beautiful facility. Function is very similar to Mitchell Hall. We're feeding 4,000 plus midshipmen three times a day.
So it looks like, although they clear a lot of the food waste, a lot of their plastics and other things end up in the trash. Assume it just goes to landfill. It seems like you'd be able to recycle that and recover a lot of the energy used in producing that plastics originally.
Yeah, they have the plastic milks, juices, and yogurts all thrown away into the trash bags.
This is the pulper before we go to the biodigester. So we're taking all this food waste, and ultimately we're going to turn it into electricity for the grid.
All right, this is like a comminuter, or? I appreciated the chance to work at the pulper. We are used to having to clean up the Navy's mess.
So this is one of our bins where we put the pulped food. And once this is filled, this is trucked over to very close near the Naval Station. All right, now we're coming over to the biodigester. I want to introduce Lieutenant Commander Jace Wisdom. He's in the Mechanical Engineering Department with me, and he's going to tell us a little bit more about this really interesting project.
So I know you saw the pulper and everything going into one of our vessels. So this is what happens to the vessels after that. Once we seal it up and make our connections to the container, this is where the magic happens. Our process takes about 5 weeks. Once we introduce the inoculate for all of our bacteria to eat the food, digest it, and make the methane gas that we're trying to collect. We think we can get 60 megawatt hours a month out of it. And we think we're gonna get a net benefit of $7,000 a month.
It seems like that's the kind of research that's really going to start spearheading how we use our waste in the future, whether it's in the Department of Defense or sometimes even industry starts to look at how we do things and try to adapt towards it a little bit.
So this is Rickover Hall. It's one of our big academic buildings. It's home to a number of engineering departments. We have classes, classrooms, offices, laboratory areas, and go ahead, take a look, see what you find.
Thank you. One thing I noticed right away is over here we've got a lot of condensation here on the sill here. Got some good air coming out through here. But then this side is actually the fan is actually missing. So maybe some opportunities. This system is kind of an older system.
Looks like these are nice double pane windows that have been replaced. I'm sure that was a lot of work put into it. It's nice to see their sunshades, but as I look down the hall, you can kind of see it's hit or miss on whether they're up or down.
I was surprised how protective I was of our spaces. I think this is a beautiful campus. I'm really proud of what we've done here. And I kind of didn't want them to find much. They found some things and really good things that we need to, you know, pay attention to and look at.
A lot of what we learned by visiting here at the Naval Academy is that we often, as engineers, will stop at the project. We install the LED lights, we call it good, and we move on. And what I've noticed through this swap is the need to focus on that behavior change in our cadets and our faculty.
It was really great to have the Air Force team on our campus. I think they exposed a lot. They opened our eyes to a lot of inefficiencies that we have here on campus, and we're excited to make some changes.
It's been so great to watch the students walk around both of the academies. Both Crystal and Scotty have been talking constantly, exchanging notes, really thinking through opportunities. And for me, it's fun to watch a new generation of energy and talent look at the buildings that we have and what might be possible in the future.
Coming up in the next episode.
I just want to thank all of you for all your help in doing this Better Building Swap.
Rickover in particular is really due for an overhaul.
We had the lights on, some of the small loads still plugged in, so it seemed like those were some areas for improvement.
The two natural rivals have found substantial energy savings across the two campuses. What makes sense? What could have the most impact? See the results of the swap in episode 3.